so we can take care of all of that for them.
In a city that bets against the odds 24 hours a day, David Wilson was unsure of his chances as he knocked on doors earlier in the year.
I want to go back to school.
Good.
We want you back.
Good.
That's the beautiful part. So come back in.
The new principal of Chaparral High School in Las Vegas had an ambitious goal, to find dropouts wherever they lived and bring them back to class. The effort was part of a citywide push known as Reclaim Your Future, targeting dropouts in Clark County, Nevada, where nearly half of all high school students fail to graduate on time.
You know, I know in my own life, you know, when I made a poor decision, usually I'm a little bit ashamed of my decision, and I'm not wanting to face the music or face somebody saying, why? But the whole point of our effort wasn't to do anything other than say you're loved, you're wanted. Please come back.
One of the dropouts Wilson and his team found was Isaiah Kimbau, a senior who stopped coming to school only a few weeks into the year.
I was pretty surprised. I didn't know that they were going to come to my house. And it made me feel like I was actually important, like they actually wanted me back. They said that they'll do anything for me to come back and basically get my diploma.
Isaiah was embarrassed that we were there, you know, but just a wonderful young man. And getting the commitment for him to come back to school and explaining the importance of having a high school diploma was huge.
Wilson came to Chaparral in 2010 when it was one of the worst performing high schools in Nevada, a state that ranks second to last in the nation, ahead of only the District of Columbia in graduation rates. That year, Chaparral was designated a turnaround school by the district, which brought financial aid from the U.S. Department of Education, but meant 50% of the staff had to go. Deputy Superintendent Pedro Martinez said the district was looking for dramatic changes at the high school that was graduating roughly one in three students at the time.
Well, you know, Chaparral is an interesting story. So almost 100% poverty. Vast majority are Latino students. I started in the district in May, and that was one of the first schools I went to go visit because I wanted to see myself. We already had decided at that point that we were going to turn it around. If you went to go see that building, it was not a clean building. It was not a building that had a great learning environment.
Clark County's efforts appear to be working for students like Kimbau, who's now on track to graduate by June and hopes to one day go to art school. But an uphill battle remains for Las Vegas, which finds itself still reeling from the hand it was dealt by the recession.
For a long time, this was the fastest growing city in the country. Casinos drove employment, employment drove housing starts, and those twin pillars, construction and entertainment, meant Vegas was one of the places you could come in America with very little education and make a decent living. But when the recession hit and the tourists stopped coming, and the bottom fell out of the housing market, this city became one of the capitals of American foreclosure and showed people just how vulnerable they were without an education.
The competition is fierce in Las Vegas.
Barbie Tivas planned to graduate from high school with the class of 1984, but she says she grew up in an abusive household and never earned a diploma after running away.
It's always your first priority in this town, is try to get something that is in the gaming industry. And so when I realized I couldn't achieve that, I went to the second best, which is food and beverage.
Tivas and her daughter Anastasia, who's also a high school dropout, are now taking online courses together in hopes of completing their GEDs. The family was hard hit by the recession, and the women are hoping that more education will boost their prospects in the future.
We were homeowners. And because I lost my job in the casinos because of the downturn of no one coming, we couldn't afford our mortgage. So like countless other people in Las Vegas, we're renters again. And I mean, we're blessed to still have a roof over our head, and a lot of people don't have that. But it's taken a long time to see the end of the rainbow.
But even on the day we were talking with Tivas, the end of the rainbow seemed elusive.
I'm on my way to a banquet server position on call, and I just found out my shift was canceled.
So they offered me a shift tomorrow, which pays substantially less than what a dinner shift pays. But I'm lucky at least they offered me a shift for tomorrow, because it's pretty standard to get canceled with nothing to replace it.
It's a frustration the Las Vegas Chamber of Commerce is well aware of, and Chamber CEO Kristen McMillan says the employment game has already changed for less educated workers.
The hotel casino jobs, the valet parking jobs, those sorts of things that were very popular amongst the younger generation, felt they didn't need high school graduation, a college education. Those jobs now are being held onto by people that have been at those properties for a very long time, and there's not likely going to be many openings in those areas for high school dropouts.
We've got a couple of things that need to happen for graduation. We've got two proficiency exams we got to pass.
Right.
Okay.
Aiming to entice new businesses to town, the Chamber is now partnering with the Clark County School District as part of the Reclaim Your Future initiative. They work together to connect mentors from the business community, like Jared Shoup from the Bank of Nevada, with high school seniors like Montel Bettis, in hopes of getting the teens across the finish line to a high school diploma.
Remember what our goal is for fourth quarter?
You get the 3.0. I've been working on that too.
On top of getting the community to recognize the need for a more educated workforce, Martinez says his district's efforts are starting to pay off in the classroom as well. And as proof, he cites the freshman class back at Chaparral High School under the leadership of Dave Wilson.
What are you reading?
In ninth grade, he has right now more children that are on track with credits than in the history of that school or in the last 10 years. And so for us, you know, that's what when we look for a turnaround, we're looking for things that change the culture, change the learning environment, and we want to see early indicators that we're going in the right track, and we're seeing that at Chaparral.
It's a type of bet the city of Las Vegas is known for, taking a chance on a once-failing high school, knowing that what looked like a long shot could end up paying off in a big way.